Finland has joined NATO in a major blow to Vladimir Putin in the wake of his invasion of Ukraine. The country today formally became the 31st member at a ceremony at the Military Alliance's Brussels headquarters. Finland's accession effectively means that if it is attacked, all NATO members would come to its aid. The UK said the move demonstrates the strength of the alliance in the face of Vladimir Putin's aggression. Finland has joined NATO in a major blow to Vladimir Putin in the wake of his invasion of Ukraine. The country today formally became the 31st member at a ceremony at the Military Alliance's Brussels headquarters. Finland's accession effectively means that if it is attacked, all NATO members would come to its aid. Sweden is also seeking to join the military alliance, but objections from Turkey and Hungary have delayed the process. The previously neutral countries signaled they wanted to come under NATO's umbrella following Russia's invasion of Ukraine. The move is a strategic and political blow to the Russian president, who has long raged at NATO's expansion. Finland has become the 31st member of NATO. Rishi Sunak welcomed Finland, becoming the newest member of the defense alliance. The prime minister said, "This is an historic day for Finland and for NATO. Their accession has made our alliance stronger and every one of us safer. All NATO members now need to take the steps necessary to admit Sweden too, so we can stand together as one alliance to defend freedom in Europe and across the world." Foreign Secretary James Cleverly, who was at NATO's headquarters, added, "Today we see, as a direct result of Vladimir Putin's aggression and his illegal invasion of Ukraine, the day where a new ally joins our defensive alliance. Russia thought its aggression would divide us. Instead, we are bound tighter together, resolute in our defense of the principles of freedom and the rule of law. Let us be clear that our door remains open. We will welcome further allies with open arms and we continue to push for Sweden's swift accession." Defense Secretary Ben Wallace said, "Let Finland be a lesson to President Putin. Finland chose to join, based on their own free will. The freedom to choose their alliances as a sovereign state is a matter for their citizens and their citizens alone." NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg said the move would make Finland safer and NATO stronger. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken hailed Finland joining NATO as a historic day. He said, "I'm tempted to say this is maybe the one thing we can thank Mr. Putin for, because he once again here has precipitated something he claims to want to prevent by Russia's aggression." But Moscow warned of countermeasures following Helsinki's accession to NATO. The Kremlin spokesman, Dmitry Peskov, said, "The Kremlin believes that this is the latest aggravation of the situation. And this forces us to take countermeasures, in tactical and strategic terms." Russia's border with member states has now doubled following Finland's accession. But the defense alliance insists it poses no threat to Moscow.
It's agreed in connection with the Madrid summit, the trilateral agreement between Finland, Sweden and Turkey. And then, of course, I also strongly believe that Turkey has some legitimate security concerns. No other ally has suffered more terrorist attacks than Turkey, and the purpose of the dialogue we now have going on in NATO is how to ensure that those security threats are addressed in a proper way.
You said recently that the failure to incorporate Sweden at the same time as Finland, something you have spent considerable time on, was not a personal setback. You clearly believe that Sweden will still get membership, but do you still genuinely believe that this is not a personal setback at this point?
I generally believe that also Sweden will become a member, and I've stated clearly that the most important thing is not that Finland and Sweden join the alliance exactly at the same time. The most important thing is that also Sweden becomes a member in the near future. We need to understand that this is so far the quickest accession process in NATO's modern history. Finland and Sweden applied in May last year. Already in June, all allies invited them to become members. And already now, less than a year after, Finland is a member, and we are working hard to then also get Sweden as a full member in the near future. We also have to understand that Sweden is in a much better and much safer position now than before they applied. Because as soon as all allies invited them, they got the status as an invitee, meaning that they are now integrated into NATO's military and civilian structures, participating in NATO military and civilian activities. And allies have provided bilateral security assurances. And also with Finland in, Sweden becomes even safer. And it's absolutely inconceivable that there will be any military threat or attack against Sweden without NATO reacting. So they are in a better place while we are working for the full-fledged membership also for Sweden.
The Ukrainian foreign minister has welcomed Finland's accession to NATO and the speed at which this has happened. He said the best way to guarantee security in Europe, which is what this is all about, at the end of the day, was to have Ukraine inside the alliance. Do you agree? And if so, when?
So NATO's position is that Ukraine will become a member of the alliance. Our immediate task, our main focus now is, of course, to provide support to Ukraine, to ensure that Ukraine prevails as a sovereign, independent nation in Europe, which is a precondition for any meaningful discussion about membership. And thirdly, we're also now starting to work on a more long-term program where we can help Ukraine move from Soviet-era doctrines, standards, equipment to NATO standards, and also to increase their interoperability with NATO forces. We have not made any decisions on when a membership can be decided. But in the meantime, we need to ensure that Ukraine prevails and that we are helping Ukraine to move towards Euro-Atlantic integration.
Well, Hungary's foreign minister says that inviting Ukraine even to NATO meetings undermines the principle of the alliance's unity. What's your response to that?
Well, I think it's important to meet with Ukraine also in the well-established forum, the NATO-Ukraine Commission, as we did yesterday with Foreign Minister Kuleba, to discuss how to sustain the unprecedented support NATO and NATO allies are providing to Ukraine, but also to discuss reforms, but also to raise issues related to minority rights. So I think it is a good thing to have a platform where we can have dialogue and also address a wide range of issues which are important for Europe, for NATO allies and for Ukraine.
Short-term, long-term for Ukraine here. Short-term, it is desperate for more ammunition. It is absolutely clear that Europe cannot manufacture that ammunition quickly enough. What are you going to do about that?